Hello everybody, welcome to another CSGO editing tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this effect that you're seeing on screen now in After Effects. To begin with, you're going to need a clip, so just import a clip like normal, create a composition with it, and I'm not going to be applying it to the entire clip because that will take too much time. I'm just going to do the bit where he pulls out the knife, so from here I'm just going to cut it, and then we're just going to stop at here. And then cut that as well. All right. Now what we need to do is duplicate this layer. So create another one and just hide that. We'll use that later. And now what we need to do is use the roto brush tool and the rotoscope the view mode out. Now I'm using just a normal 60fps clip that I recorded with Fraps. If you're recording with something like Merv Streams, you won't actually have to do this because you'll get the separate layers. It'll actually be a lot easier because you won't have to do the process of rotoscoping the view model. Anyway, I have a normal clip, so I'm going to be rotoscoping it. So I'm sure a lot of you probably know how to rotoscope already, but for those that don't, what you need to do is double click on the clip and select the roto brush tool. And what you need to do is just paint out the bit that you want to keep. So if I just move down here, if I just increase the size, you can see there's a green circle. If I paint this section in, it essentially marks it in like a pink outline. That is the bit we're going to be keeping. You can increase the size by holding control and just clicking and dragging. It makes it bigger and smaller. If you have a bit that you don't want to keep, so let's just say it selected this area and you don't actually want to keep that, hold Alt on your keyboard, it will turn red and just sort of delete it like that. So that is essentially rotoscoping, and we need to go through and do the entire process. With the new roto brush 2 tool, it actually makes it a lot easier. What you have to do is press play and it will sort of automatically roto brush the bits you want. It is not perfect, but you can actually go back and fix all of it manually. As you can see, there you go. It has a rough outline. It's pretty decent for doing it automatically. But as you can see, it misses a lot of parts. So we're going to need to go back and fix it up. Alright, so as you can see, I've now done rotoscoping out the view model. Obviously, you can spend a lot more time, you know, making it nice and clean and refining each of the edges. I'm not going to do that simply to save some time for this video. But if you go back into the main composition, you can see that the view model is now cut out like so. It doesn't have to be perfect. You can obviously perfect it if you really want to, but I'm not going to do that. Alright, so once you have everything rotoscoped, we need to duplicate this layer twice. So once we have that, we can hide those layers. For the first layer, we need to add fine edges. Add that to your clip, just click invert like so. Then add S_clouds_psycho. And we need to set this combined to malt like so. And set the frequency to something like 0.2, maybe 0.15. You can play around with the settings if you wish to do so. It just changes the frequency, as it says, as well as the color. So you can play around with that to whatever you like. Next, we need to add levels and bring the right arrow to the left. So just drag that in like so to make everything nice and bright. And you may want to bring the right arrow in a bit just to get rid of some of the noise in the some of the rough noise in the view model like so. So I think that's pretty decent. That should do. And then we just need to add deep glow to the clip, like so. Makes everything nice and bright. Might want to turn down the radius a bit. So I usually set it to about 300. I think that's pretty decent. And once we have that done, we need to set the mode of the layer to add. And we can enable the other layers, like so. That's what it looks like so far. You may want to play around the different glow settings. It might be a bit too much for your liking. I'm just going to leave it. Maybe turn down to about 200. We can skip the second one, that will be left default. For the third one, we need to add S Cloud Psycho again. Same as before, set the same frequency. So I did 0.15. And then we need to add turbulent displace to the clip. For displacement, just leave it at turbulent. For amounts, you may want to increase this to something about 100 and or something. You may want to reduce the size a bit, but what you need to do is increase the complexity. So I'm just going to crank it to about 6-ish. It's around 6.3 or so. And you may want to play one of the different sizes. So I like to bring this down a bit to around this point, around 40. Maybe increase the amount or something. And once you have that done, just set this to add as well. And there you go, that is the effect done. Now, if you wish to do so, you can actually keyframe the evolution of the turbulent displacement. That will essentially move around the turbulent displace on the clip, like so. What you need to do is press the stopwatch button and keyframe it. It's pretty simple to do. So yeah, that's pretty much the effect done. Now, I normally don't do effect tutorials anymore simply because they become pretty overused. But I've gotten hundreds of messages asking how to do this. So now here's the video. So yeah, hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next one.